Yeah, I was gonna say, Shelly, you did ask that, I'll do this all.
Okay, so I think you can hear me, but if again, if we want to gather together here, so we can all be together, and on behalf of Dana and Kristen, On behalf of Dana and Chris, I want to welcome all of you here this afternoon as we celebrate your coming together in holy matrimony and the holy bond of marriage. This is a special occasion in their lives. It creates a new future for them. Also, it's a joyous time for all of us. We have the privilege of being witnesses as they commit their lives to one another in the covenant of marriage. The scripture says that a man should leave his father and mother and cleave to his wife, and that the two shall become one flesh. God is the one who has established marriage. It was his idea. Marriage is not something to be done lightly, but it is to be entered in with the highest level of commitment. Let's pray together. Father in heaven, we come before you sharing this special time with Dana and Kristen as they come together in the covenant of Christian marriage. They do this seeking your blessing on their commitment and their life together. And as they make their vows to each other today, cause them to be vows that are written on their hearts by your Holy Spirit. We ask you to bless their love for one another, and may that love be truly anchored in their love for you. We pray this in the name of your Son, the Lord Jesus Christ, our Savior. Amen.
Amen.
And having come before the Lord in the presence of these witnesses, do you, Dana, take Kristen to be your lawfully wedded wife? And do you promise before God and these witnesses that you will be to her a true and devoted husband? Do you pledge your loyalty to her and promise to love, honor, and comfort and keep her in health and in sickness and prosperity and an adversary and forsaking all others? Do you promise that you will keep yourself for her and for her only, so long as you both shall live?
I do.
If this is your intention, please say, I do.
I do.
Very good. And Kristen, do you likewise take Dana to be your lawfully wedded husband? And do you promise before God and these witnesses that you will be to him a true and devoted wife? Do you pledge your loyalty to him and promise to love, honor, and comfort, and keep him in health and in sickness and in prosperity and adversary and forsaking all others? Do you promise that you will both keep yourself for him and for him only, so long as you both shall live? If this is your intention, please say, I do.
I do.
I do. Thank you. At this time, Lexi is going to come, and Lexi and Hector are going to lead us in a song or have special music.
Right there, save me.
with you makes perfect sense. You're my best friend.
Well, it's good to be together today and to be able to celebrate with Dana and Kristen. And you guys finally made it. It's seemed like it's been a while before the ceremony came. I know there was a lot of stress and anxiety, but it's great that you're here today. And it's been a privilege, actually, for me to meet Dana and Kristen and do some premarital counseling with them for a few months. And it's really been a special privilege for me. And I'd like to share a few thoughts with Dana and Kristen, and I hope that you would join with me as we think about some advice and things that we could share with them. And I know that it's their desire, and again, meeting with them, that their desire is that they might have a Christ-centered marriage, that God would be the center of the relationship. And really, this is the key foundation to have a successful marriage today. And I know that each of you have received Jesus Christ into your life, that you have asked him to forgive you of your sin, and you've invited him to come in to be the Lord of your life. And the idea here is, once you receive Christ, is that you want to continually grow. And I want to encourage both of you, as you are growing together in your relationship with one another and with Jesus Christ, that you would remain faithful to reading the Bible, his word of truth, that you would spend time together in prayer, that you would also fellowship in the local church, so that you would, these are things that God has established so that you could grow in your walk with him. And the scripture says, as we read, that the scripture says that a husband shall leave his wife, that a husband and wife shall become one flesh, to become one physically and emotionally and spiritually, that two become one. And as we think of that, it's for two people to become one, it's not an easy task to do. We realize that both of you are coming from different backgrounds, that you're male and female, and neither of you are perfect as someone else is perfect. And so the idea is, how can two people become one? And the Bible really gives some good ways in which that is going to happen. I wanted to share some of those things with you briefly this afternoon. And so to have a successful marriage, one of the first things you must have is love for each other. And obviously, just coming together, you say, well, that's pretty obvious. You wouldn't be here if you didn't love one another. But the love that the Bible's talking about is a sacrificial love. And as we look at Scripture, it says that love is patient, love is kind, it does not envy, it does not boast, it's not proud, it does not dishonor each other, it's not self-seeking, it's not easily angered, it keeps no records of wrongs, it always protects, it always hopes, it always trusts. Love never fails. And that type of love that the Bible's talking about is a giving love. You know, many people today marry another person for the goal of what they can get. And so oftentimes that love is about getting and not giving. And so the Bible talks about this love that is sacrificial. It's talking about the same love that God had when he sent his son Jesus into the world to save us from sin. It says, for God so loved the world that he gave. And so that's the idea. As two people come together, they are giving to one another, not taking. And so when you have two people loving and giving to one another, it makes for a very strong marriage. Secondly, as we think of not just love, but a commitment, the scripture says that a man should leave his father and his mother and cleave to his wife. And when you become married, your primary relationship is with one another. Many things and circumstances can come in and interfere in a marriage. And that can become a wedge between the two of you. Your jobs, people, demands of life can easily become a wedge between the two of you. You have to say, no, we're committed to one another.
and you must guard against these things so that you are spending quantity and quality time together. A third area that the Bible speaks about is the idea of transparency, that communication, and we've talked about this as we met together, that communication is so essential in a relationship. It's important to have the freedom and the oneness to share with each other. Communication includes the ability to listen to each other as well, to respect what each other says, taking time to share the concerns in each other's lives. It's important to have that commitment and transparency. The other thing is forgiveness. The Bible says that love keeps no records of wrongs. You know, in any relationship, and today you might not be thinking this, but in any relationship, things can be said and done that offend and hurt each other. And there has to be forgiveness. There can't be any room for resentment and bitterness to grow in your relationship. The Bible says, don't let the sun go down on your anger. Don't let Satan get a foothold. In other words, deal with anger quickly. You know, don't harbor resentment and bitterness, because it's like a cancer that can destroy your relationship. Just a couple more. The other one is encouragement. You know, helping each other through tough times. Love gives hope to each other. You want to have the concept that your marriage has a team approach, that you're working together. You want your home to be a place of, a haven of rest, a place where you look forward to be with each other. And then one last one is grace. You know, that being gracious. And what is grace? It's unmerited love, undeserving love. It's what God gives to us. No one is perfect. We each give give each other the benefit of the doubt. We overlook each other's faults. Love is patient and it's gracious. And if I could have one more thing that I would say to each of you, is to have fun. Enjoy your life together. Realize that God has brought the two of you together, and that you need to work at these things, but enjoy each other and enjoy His blessings in the years to come. God has designed and ordained marriage. When we follow His principles, when we walk in obedience, God can bring two people together and make them one. You have His blessing, and my prayer is that your marriage will bring honor and glory to Him.
Bumblebee.
And with those thoughts in mind, what tokens do you give as an expression of your love and commitment to one another?
Come on. I see it.
Is a beautiful symbol of what your marriage is meant to be. And as a ring is continuous and knows no end, may your love for one another also know no end. Now I'm going to have Dana, if you're going to put this ring on Kristen's finger. You have your vows. Dana and Kristen have written each other vows to one another, and Dana's going to share his vows to Kristen at this time. If you want to speak right in that mic.
I, Dana, take you, Kristen, to be my wife. Ever since I met you in June of 2012, I knew you was very special and that we would become great friends. In fact, you are my best friend that I care so much about. I promise to stand by you no matter what happens in life and will bring out the best in you. I will always protect you and keep you safe. May my heart be your shelter and my arms be your home. I can't wait to start our own family in our beautiful house. As this ring has no end nor beginning, so shall my love for you be. As I place it on your finger, I give you all that I am and all that I shall become.
This ring. And Kristen, if you would say your vows.
Today before God and surrounded by our friends and family, I, Kristen, take you, Dana, as you are now and who you are yet to become as my husband. I promise to always listen to you with compassion and understanding, to learn from you, to support you as you strive to achieve your goals and accept your support. I promise to stand by you always, to laugh with you, enjoy joyful times and struggle alongside you in whatever sorrow life may bring us. I vow not to just grow old, but to grow old together as we create and support a family in a home filled with laughter, patience, understanding, and love, and to build a life far better than either of us could imagine alone. I marry you with no hesitation or doubt, and my commitment to you is absolutely for better, for worse, for richer, for poorer, in sickness and in health, to love and to cherish till death do us part, for as long as we both shall live.
Let's pray together. Father, as Dana and Kristen have exchanged their vows and pledged their lives to each other before you, I pray that you would bless them and cause their hearts to be knit together with the powerful cords of love. As they have exchanged rings as symbols of their love and their faith in each other, cause their faith, their love and faith also to be directed toward you. Lord, I ask that you would sustain them in their life together. Be with them as they grapple with the trials of life. Supply them with a joy and contentment that comes from knowing you. And may their life together truly bring honor and glory to your holy name. And we pray this in the name of Jesus, our Savior, our Lord. Amen.
Amen.
And now by the authority committed to me as a minister of the gospel of Jesus Christ, in accordance with the laws of the state of Connecticut, I pronounce that Kristen and Dana are husband and wife in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit, whom therefore God has joined together. Let no one ever divide or separate. Dana, you can kiss your bride. And now it gives me great pleasure to present to you Mr. and Mrs. Dana.
Yeah, right.
I know.
Stop.